Thank you. move. Audit. Push audit, this is. Support practice and performance review. And the third is coming? Okay, so. Audit, practice, performance, review, and practicing. Audit, practice, and performance, review, and practicing. So, our first topic of discussion is the law unit number one. Unit one, we're looking at the law of purchasing in an organization. The role of purchasing in an organization. So, what did you study?
I studied
procurement. Okay, did it. Very good. So, which means you must trust it, right? You can procurement, yeah? Okay, so if you look at this topic or this course, it's about a number of units. What is practice? There is what is practice, and we also have what we call performance. Procuring things for the organization. You might work for an organization that does contract, that wins contract. You see, you are going to construct a road somewhere, they're going to build a house somewhere, they're going to build a school somewhere. So your role is to procure raw materials, to provide them raw materials. You buy raw materials from the supplier and you give to those that are trying to fulfill the need of a particular contract, isn't it? To construct something. Construction only materials. Okay? Road construction only materials. Road maintenance only materials. Even if you are working for a furniture organization, maybe they are into furniture. For them to produce the furniture, they only need materials. So your job is to procure. Okay. Now, in this course, we're simply looking at audit and the performance of the business. So, here we're not looking at the buying itself, but we're looking at reviewing the process. Okay, you've done, someone has done, your junior has done the buying. So, you're looking at the process. How did it go? Did they follow the procedures? What happened? What really happened in the course of procurement? Was procurement done as expected? All those things, isn't it? So, when we talk of audit, we know audit is all about independent work. Auditing is an independent review of what? Processes, okay? So in this case, we're talking about the practice, we're looking at independent review of procurement. Okay, or another way, purchasing what? Process. Independent review of procurement or purchasing process. Independent means someone is independent when that person is not part of the whole process, isn't it? The person was not involved in the buying of things, isn't it? Someone was involved in the buying. So your role is to independently check or review how the buying was conducted. Okay. How the buying, how the procurement, how the purchasing of those particular items or materials were done out there. So, this person has to be independent. In other words, has to look physically independent, emotionally independent, psychologically independent. So, this person has to be very objective. Has to look at things with what? Objectivity. You should not be subjective. Okay. So, that objectivity, that independence of what we're looking at. The main reason is, we're trying to say, look at, have we followed all the procedures when we are trying to procure these materials? Did we follow all the processes that have been set in the organization? Have we followed all the protocols that have been set? Okay. Did we use shortcuts in the course of procuring these materials? So, that is what we're trying to check. If at all, the person who was buying complied with what? The set rules, set procedure, set systems of the organization. So that's what I say, audit reflecting. So, performance review is the same thing. You are looking at something that's been done, so you're looking at how have you performed. Are we in conformity with the certain rules and regulations? Are we compliant with the procurement act, procurement rules? That I say. So it's all about checking, trying to check and trying to ask ourselves if at all we have done the right thing, isn't it? If at all what we have done is in line with what has been said by the nation. What we're doing is in line with the systems. We are following all the procedures. So that's performance review, or that's what we call the audit practice. So in this case, when you're talking about this topic, what you have about is we're checking what someone has done or what we have done. We're trying to check what have an audit eye. Or in other words, we're trying to look at things, eh? You are a procurement officer, but you also have an audit eye. Say, what if an audit comes? Is he going to be satisfied with the work that we're doing? Is he going to say we have complied with all regulations? So, you're looking at the procurement process with a procurement eye and an audit what? Eye. If I'm auditing my work, would I say, would I be satisfied with what I'm doing? Is the process done in compliance with what the policies, the procedures are saying? Do we have the systems in place to guide us? Are we following those systems? So that's not about audit practice and become a review with practice. Okay. Now let's look at unit number one. We are looking at the role of purchasing in an organization. You know, purchasing, or in other words, procurement. It's more of a sense, isn't it? Purchasing or procurement. Purchasing looks a bit old. Procurement looks a bit modern, but it's the same thing, isn't it? So, purchasing, in any and in each and every organization, the purchasing or procurement department plays a critical role. Procurement and purchasing department plays a critical role. In other words, this department that engages in procurement is of paramount importance, plays a greater role in an organization. In most organizations, you find that most of their expenses, almost maybe 70 to 80% of the expenses go to procurement or purchasing what? Department. Okay? Okay? For example, if you're producing maize flour, isn't it? You have a company that's producing maize flour. You have another company, you have HR, you have marketers, you have the ET, and you have procurement department. You find that because you are a production or a processing company, what's happening? For you to process, you need what? Raw materials. Okay? You need raw materials. And these raw materials, you need raw materials. And these raw materials are, in other words, are inputs. That are bought before you buy these as inputs. And these inputs will be processed and produce what we call the output. Okay. So in other words, what I'm saying is that these inputs have to be bought somewhere. What are these inputs? Maize. You say you have to buy, I don't know what do they, what are the other things that they use to process flour? They could be.
Part of the deal, isn't it?
So that's why we are saying all these practices have to be very much emphasized in those particular departments. Okay. So what I'm saying is that procurement plays a critical role in our organization and also in the supply chain one management decision. So procurement plays also a great role in the supply chain one. Supply chain management decisions. It is a very good department playing critical roles in our organization. Now, what is the role of purchasing in an organization? So I say purchasing process or the procurement process is responsible for selecting suppliers, isn't it? So the purchasing itself, the process of purchasing is responsible. You know what? Responsible for what? Selection of what? Suppliers. Negotiation of what? Negotiating and administration of long-term contract. So, as a purchasing person, as a procurement person, you have a role to play. So, one thing, the procurement department has for the first one, selecting suppliers. If you need someone to supply you with specific goods and services, then the procurement department has to do that for you. You have to identify who is going to supply as required low materials. That's the role of the purchasing. Not only selecting, but also they have to what? Negotiate what? Negotiate contract. They have to negotiate. Isn't it? Negotiating you, isn't it? We want to buy from you. What price are you offering your product, isn't it? So the supplier will say, you say, no, this is a tool. We can, your cost doesn't meet our budget. Can we have a win-win situation here? So, you negotiate, say, no, I think, may you please reduce the price? So that process is the process of purchasing. So the purchasing has to play that one role in that particular organization. So, yeah, Komatsu has a role to monitor performance of our supplier. So monitoring supplier performance. If you engage a supplier today, then at the end of the year, what do? You have to assess that particular supplier. How has this supplier performed? You see? So this assessment is very important. Daniel?
Yes.
So this supplier good organization when it comes to acquiring what? Goods or services or materials needed. So participant has the role to acquire goods or services or materials needed by the organization in order to fulfill it, to fulfill their goals. So companies will set goals, or the procurement will be done. Companies have goals. So procurement is a process that will be initiated in order to fulfill the goals of the company, isn't it? If your goal is to produce a number of products, then procurement is there to bring in raw materials or services that will help the company to produce the number of types of products that they want to produce, isn't it? So in this case, I say procurement process will help in acquiring, to acquire base materials at the time, or materials, goods, or other parts, services that are needed to fulfill the goals of the company. So that's the role of the procurement. Then, so the procurement also, the procurement of the supply should also ensure that the company
the role of procurement in organizations
What are these 3 main categories? Who said we need a resource? Requisition.